My name is Michael Hübler. I'm leading the chair for Embedded Systems in Information Technology since 2012 here at the Ruhr University of Bochum. And the topic is about embedded systems in general, but especially developing embedded systems for novel Industry 4.0, Internet of Things application. And I'm going from the processor design over hardware design until application implementation onto this new hardware. The Ruhr University is one of the youngest universities in Germany. It was founded in 1965, so we had last year the 50th anniversary. The Ruhr University is the sixth biggest university in Germany with over 40,000 students and around 5,000 employees here. It is for our region a very important place for work, for technology transfer, where we interact with other universities from the region, you know, North Rhine-Westphalia. So therefore, with our neighbors in Dortmund, Duisburg, Essen and so forth, we cooperate a lot. And we have here a very dense network of universities and from that point of view, also a lot of students and absolvents, and are a very attractive place for students to live here. Cadence software is highly important for my research since the topic we look for is also in embedded systems design is about electronic design automation. So, and as you know, high-level synthesis, for example, is a very hot topic currently in embedded systems design. So going from a high level of abstraction down to, for example, a realization on hardware, for example, on FPGA, but also on ASIC. So Cadence software, as one example for high-level synthesis, is very, very important for us. So this is a new Stratus tool which we use here. And on the next topic where we use Cadence software is on virtual system prototyping. So we use these platforms to develop embedded systems, mainly at the moment in the automotive domain, where we develop electronic control units and connect them to demonstrators. So as one example, we have here a car simulator where we connect virtual electronic control units to this simulator and look then how the behavior of this electronic control unit is in combination with the car simulator.
Hi, my name is Finn Schwiegelsohn. I'm a PhD student at the Ruhr University of Bochum, and we're presenting here at Cadence the car door anti-trap protection using the Cadence virtual system platform. The main challenge that we tried to tackle here was designing an ECU software without having the actual hardware for this ECU design. We designed this ECU software completely in a virtual environment that is running on the PC. Now, the car door anti-trap protection works seamlessly even on a virtual system, so we don't have any delays in the execution of this anti-trap protection. I can show you this. If I'm sticking my finger inside the door, I won't have an injury because the car door will detect my hand and it will reverse just in time. The added benefit now that we have this hardware is we can extract the project from the virtual system platform and insert it into this hardware, and then it works seamlessly with the whole setup.
In another PhD topic, we look for formal verification, where, for example, Jasper is a hot topic where we look for. And then in future, I would like to emphasize my activity also in chip design, ASIC design, standard cell design. And so in the next time, I will gain my experience more also in that direction. And then the Cadence tools will play a major role. When I started my chair here in 2012, then the active time started with the Cadence Academic Network, and from that time I was always included in, of course, the CDN Live, where we had meetings and where we presented our work in the academic track. But on top of this, I'm also try to actively communicate with the other partners from the academic network to exchange knowledge. For example, with a group from Kerstin-Eder, I exchanged information about formal verification. And in future, with Professor Brüning, I will exchange information about the chip design for standard cells. On top of this, we try to arrange also events in conferences. So, for example, we organized workshops at the Design Automation and Test in Europe conference. We had some arrangements where we discussed some topics about the academic network. And this year at the Design Automation conference, we will organize a workshop where we show the audience how an academic network can help to ramp up the career of young scientists, which is very helpful because in combination with such a constellation in an academic network, it is very helpful to get access to knowledge, and you need not too long time to ramp up your business. Of course, academic network helps us to be in line with the newest technology of Cadence. So we discuss in the meetings and we have in the academic network, we have telephone conferences, so we hear what activity is going on. So this helps me to, let's say, stay with my research at the leading edge. So this is very important for me.